Obeying through the Word of God and through the Holy Spirit, but use your brains and pray. But we people of God, we are totally different. We are called by the Spirit of God to discern things and to see things in the Spirit. The Bible on honoring your leaders. Maybe by now you think, well, this Dwight, that's my name. He is bowing down for pastors. He's saying I have to obey them and honor them and give them all the credit and honor and money. No, 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 I'm not saying that. Don't twist my words. But let's read what the Bible tells us about honoring your leaders. I start in Hebrews chapter 13, verse 7. Remember those who led you, who spoke the word of God to you, and considering the result of their way of life, imitate their faith. Verse 17. Obey your leaders and submit to them, for they keep watch over your souls as those who will give an account, so that they may do this with joy, not groaning, you hear me, not groaning, for this would be unhelpful for you. Obedience. Obedience is not blind obedience. He is not a sergeant major, your pastor, you have to do this, you have to do this, you have to do it, you have to obey, you have to obey, obey, obey. No, it's not blind obedience. First of all, God has given you brains. Use them. Use your wisdom. You have brains. Use them. And God gave you another tool. Prayer. Go on your knees and ask the Holy Spirit. My pastor asked me this and this and this. Is it from you or not? So we're not talking about blind obedience. We are talking about obeying through the Word of God and through the Holy Spirit. But use your brains and pray. Imitate their faith. Look at their life, say, I want to have this in my life. Imitate those things in their life that are defined, that are godly. For they keep watch over your souls as those who will give an account. They will give an account one day. They are accountable for what they did, how they treated their sheep. Because they received the sheep, God entrusted the sheep, the members of the church, to this pastor. So he one day will have to give an account. Not only one day, but every day, the Holy Spirit is speaking to him. And it's a heavy task. So that they may do this with joy, not groaning. That's up to you. Do you help the pastor with joy or with groaning? The choice is yours. I give you another scripture. 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 12 and 13. But we ask you, brothers and sisters, to recognize those who diligently labor among you and are in leadership over you in the Lord and give instruction, and that you will regard them very highly in love because of their work. Live in peace with one another. So that's your attitude towards your leaders, towards your pastor, with love and help them. Now the scripture, 1 Timothy chapter 5 verse 17. The elders who lead well are to be considered worthy of double honor, especially those who work hard at preaching and teaching. We're living in a time when it's fashionable, when it's okay to criticize your leaders, whether they are pastor or president, or whatever function they have of authority. You have to criticize them, you have to discern what's happening over there. But we people of God, we are totally different. We are called by the Spirit of God to discern things and to see things in the Spirit. Thank you.